让我们掌声有请画家何嘉良博士发表感言。
Mr. Edwin Tan, Minister of State, Ms. Lau Sing Ni, NAFA Board Chairman, Mr. Stephen Leung, President of Federation of Art Societies, and Chairman, Organizing Committee,Mr. Tan Rui Rong, various presidents of art societies who are present here, and distinguished guests, fellow artists, ladies and gentlemen, very good afternoon to all of you. Well, in fact, today I'm very honored.And thankful to Mr. Edwin Tan for gracefully accepting my invitation to become the GOH Voice of Honor for my many solo art exhibition. Thank you, Edwin. Well, next, I would also like to thank NAFA Board Chairman.Miss Madam Lau Sing Ling for her kind words. She actually she was my colleague when I was in the Ministry of Education the year I think 1980 something. Yeah. So.Madam Lau Sing Ling, she was also handpicked by Dr. Goh Keng Swee to become one of the system engineers to revamp the Ministry of Education. So she had contributed quite a lot of in.The education of Singapore. So I would also like to take this opportunity to congratulate her for being conferred the Public Service Medal by our President this National Day. Thank you. Well, I also want to thank.The kind words expressed by the former speakers. I don't think I deserve all those praise. I only do my humble part to help develop the art.Seen in Singapore. Over the year, I also did that. Well, you know, art is my instinct. It's my instinct. I think most probably this will be a lifelong instinct. Ever since I was in secondary school,but we call high school, because Chongqing High School, it was my first, secondary school. So from there, I had a very good teacher in art. So from there on, I was very interested in the art. So I participate in various art activities. I love nature. I like those very rustic scenes of kampongs. In the last century, 50, 60, and 70 years, still have kampongs. But you have to be very fast to paint or draw them before they were given way for urban renewal. So I managed to paint quite a number of kampongs on display today. One of my very old kampong scene is the Kampong Irau, which is in Sembawang. Of course, not now it already vanished, no more there. And then the other one is a Kampong Buangkok, which is the only remaining Malay kampong on the Singapore proper. Of course, in Pulau Ubin, there's still some kampong, but those are not like the Malay kampong. Those are mainly Chinese houses. So it's quite different from the Malay type of architecture. So this is the kampong scene and other scene, because my forte is plein air painting. I like to paint, you know, in the open. I like to paint the scene in front of me, because I believe if the subject matter is not revoke your passion, you hardly can paint or draw a painting that will strike the echo of your audience. So this is something that I make it a point that I must draw on the spot. So all these 10 pieces of painting were painted on the spot. Even those are overseas painting also. I have to bring my easel and my all the materials to paint. But lately, because of the pandemic, I have to stay safe at home. Very hard for me to go out to pay. So what am I to do? So nothing to do. I cannot keep myself ready either. So I had to do some woodcuts, prints, and some calligraphy to pass my time. On display here, there are three categories. First is 10 pieces of painting in oil and acrylic. And second category is the woodcut prints. And third is the calligraphy. Woodcut, now very few people to do. You know why? Because we can't, the process is very tedious. You have to have first a draft, and then you transfer the draft to a wood. You have to carve the wood, and then you have to print. You use printing oil, and then you print it on rice paper or other papers. So the process is quite easy. So now people will not do such a thing. But that was my interest from the last last century, 50s or 60s, at that time, you know, quite a number of people, yeah, including some very famous lecturers in NAFA, they do wake-ups. I also, influenced by them, followed. Those times, because the NAFA lecturers or students, they were influenced by Chinese, you know, woodcut printer. Because at that time, in China, there's one very famous writer, Lu Xun. He brought the tenet of woodcut to China. Why? Because he said that woodcut is a very good tool for propaganda. So at that time, Chinese is in turbulent period. So he introduced this to China. Many artists did that. In Singapore, we also influenced by them. I also influenced by my teacher. So he did. But we all self-taught. We are not there. There was no woodcut teachers, or print teachers to teach us. Woodcut is one of the prints. In the category of print, there are quite a number. Woodcut is one of them only. On display this few, five pieces, two old woodcut. I did it in last century. The three say quite recent works. So I hope you enjoy looking at. And then the third category is the calligraphy. Calligraphy, you know, is the treasure of Chinese civilization. So calligraphy is easy to learn, but hard to excel. Some even, you know, you spend the whole time, whole life, you cannot write very good calligraphy. Well, calligraphy has quite a number of style, they call it scripts. It developed from the ancient time, some 2,000 to 3,000 years ago till now. So we have quite a number of stuff. The oracle or the script, the seal script and the running script and so on, so forth. So, you know, for the ink, this ink is very good, you know, material to use for calligraphy, because, you know, people think that ink is only a monochrome, one color, black. But the clever Chinese, we say that, no, ink has five colors, in inverted commas, five colors. I interpreted it as different degree of dilution, which means you add water to the ink, add more or less, then will become, you have the toner, you know, effect. So I tried this using this, you know, then to see bread and not bread, we call it medium weight or whatever. Because it has five colors. This is only two or three colors. I hope you all like it. This is the whole exhibition of my exhibition today. So I hope you enjoy my exhibition, and if you have any feedback, I welcome. I welcome your feedback so that I can improve myself. Right? Now may I say a few words in Mandarin? 政务部长陈胜辉先生，主席，谭瑞荣先生，还有南艺的董事会主席刘兴宁女士，还有我们的会长梁振康先生，各花卉的会长。 各位嘉宾，各位同道，女士们、先生们，大家下午好。首先呢，我感到非常荣幸，能够得到我们的陈胜辉政务部长呢，一口就答应。 为我这个展览就是开幕，所以我这样，谢谢陈部长，谢谢你，下来我要感谢这个梅总会长梁振康先生，以及这个我们主席，替我主办这样的一个。 展览，虽然场地比较小，展的这个展览品也不是太多，但是呢也摆设的非常专业，很有这个一种气氛，所以我也要感谢他们，那么这里展出的是分三大类。 第一类就是油画跟胶彩，油画跟胶彩呢，就是我的写生的作品，因为我的比较强项就是到户外呢去写生，不论是在新加坡呢还是到国外，希望呢能够有机会。 在户外的写生，这个是我的一种自己对这个美术的热爱。这个我对美术的这个热爱是从中学时代就开始，那时候有很好的老师叶志威老师啦，杨慧明老师啦。 还有邱高芬老师等等，那么我得到了他们的这个教诲，所以那时候起就对绘画很有兴趣了，那么就有一个时期也到美专去进修一年半，所以有一些基础了，那么从那时候起呢就别没有说停过这个艺术活动了。 有时候因为太忙了，从政以后就比较少时间去作画了，不过呢还是有替一些同道的画展组织开幕啊等等，所以开幕的次数也非常繁多了，那我认为说这个是我的一种责任呢，也帮助我们的同道来发展这个艺术了，所以呢这个。 写生的作品呢，大家就可以看到能够表现 表现了一种热情呢，因为你如果对于你眼前的景物没有发生一种感情，你就不会画出很好的作品。这个是写生的一个要诀，所以这师傅的写生作品呢，有一两幅是比较旧，旧的甘榜酒，马来甘榜，马来甘榜以前在新加坡有好多个甘榜了，我讲的这幅呢是比较老的甘榜，甘榜一楼是在三巴湾的一个甘榜，当然这些甘榜都因为城市的发展啊，一个一个的就消失掉，所以我们呢要写生要赶快，赶那时间，在它还没有消失之前要赶快去画，也画了一些，也有一些画不到了，因为太迟，它已经消失了，拆掉了哦。这个就是我们画家的写生作品的这种一种乐趣跟一种困难呐 那么第二类的作品就是五幅木刻的展览这木刻在中国动乱的时代由这个中国的大文豪鲁迅先生提倡介绍这个木刻到中国，他请日本的专家来讲那个木刻的讲演戏班，让很多中国的画家掌握了这个木刻的技术，然后呢他们就利用这个木刻当作一种宣传的工具所以他们的题材呢都是跟这些民生有关系的所以我们新加坡在去上世纪六七十年代也受了中国的影响了，有好多美专的老师都掌握了这个技术美专老师出名的好像徐准地老师还有林永泉老师还有这个林木化老师他们都做木刻都非常棒，那我也学一学了，当然这些都是自学的了，没有说上这个美这个版画课等等的，不像现在就有了是自己画课课有了就投稿，投到报馆也登了登了就给你稿费，你懂稿费多少？5块钱，5块钱稿费给你，那时候的5块钱也是相当不错了为什么呢？因为那时候呢你要买一盘面的话差不多是10分而且是最多是20分所以你5块钱可以买很多东西吃所以呢我们就因为有这样的酬劳，所以就很热心的去客了，客人很多我是等到从政了没有这样多时间客了因为木刻是很繁杂的这个过程所以就停了到了我退休了以后呢才重新拿起这刻刀来做所以就刻了一些，特别在现在疫情肆虐的期间我就很少出外，就在家呢就做一些木刻，就是就写字，将来消磨这个时间所以这个是第二类的展品一共有五幅，有两幅是比较老的，大家可以看到之前还有三幅是比较近的那我对于那些难民的遭遇我非常同情， 所以我有刻过好几幅有关这个难民的这种逃难图了啊，也有在我们的赵振强的画廊展览过啊。那么这幅是比较新的难民，我的题目是难民的悲歌啊。你看那个难民啊，从他原来的地方乘这个船过来啊，经过很辛苦的这个海水路啊，上了岸，这老太婆已经精疲力竭啊，所以他只好蹲在那边休息，就描绘了这样的一个情况。哦，那么第三类呢，就是书法就是中国的国粹啦，大家知道啊，是好几千年历史传下来的啊，从这个甲骨文啊，到各种的这个书体啊，到这个草书啦等等哈，很多种啊。那么要掌握这个书法啊，学书法是容易，但是要精就比较难，就是易学难精的啊一个书法。那么书法的话是用这个墨啊，写在宣纸或者其他的纸上面。这个墨的话呢，是很有这个创造性的啊，因为中国人说墨分五色，墨你说墨是黑的吗？怎么五个颜色呢？啊，原来墨呢，你掺了水呢，它不是就浓淡的程度就不同了啊，就会产生了一种呢不同的这个效果。我这五幅呢就尝试一下，用这个方法，用两色或者三色来写这些字。我希望大家看了给我一些批评，看看怎么样子啊。所以呢，今天就是将20幅的作品就呈现给大家了啊，大家看过给我一些批评，让我好的可以改进，要不吝赐教啊。还有各位，因为我知道很多这个画家朋友的都非常棒的啊，所以希望大家呢不吝赐教哈，谢谢啊，谢谢。
1 2 3 到这里就要告一段落了。画展展出日期是2021年8月26日至8月29日，每天上午11时至傍晚6时，8月30日上午11时至傍晚5时。欢迎您邀请朋友前来观展。现在呢，请大家自由的观赏，并保持1米的距离。谢谢各位。请大家注意，拍照的时候限定为5人，请保持距离，谢谢。